Hi, welcome to my desk. My name is Ashley, and I have some work to do. I'm guessing you do too, which is why you're here, which is great because we are about to work together for 1 hour in real time using the Pomodoro technique. That means we'll do 2 25-minute work sections. During those work sections, we will blast the white noise and we will focus on the task at hand. Ashley, what counts as a task? Oh, anything you need to do. Homework, great. Cleaning your house, great. Scrapbooking, excellent. If it's on your to-do list, it is worthy of those work sections. Right in the middle, we'll have a 5-minute break where you can get up and stretch, maybe refill your beverages, maybe memorize all the characteristics of each zodiac sign, do whatever you want, take that time for yourself. It is a break. If you want a little human interaction though, I will be here chatting about a certain subject as always, so you can stay with me. And then after the hour, we are free to close our computer, to leave our work area, to go out into the world with the confidence, with the knowledge that we already showed up, we already sat down, we already took care of business. How does that sound? Great. So today I'm drinking a seltzer and I am going to be doing some research for the first 25 minutes. I would love to know what you're going to work on and what beverages you have. Wonderful. Well, let's get comfortable. Make sure everything's just how you like it. Check in on Riker and Picard. You feel good? Are you ready? You know the first 25 minutes flies by. You ready? Great, I'm gonna count us in. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Ding, 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 ding. Putting 5 minutes on the clock. Come out of your deep thoughts. Woo, let's have a little break, shall we? Let's do some stretches with the shoulders back, forward, side to side. Ooh, you know, my favorite stretch, this one. There we go. Feels good. Oh, there we go. Okay, let's pick up where we left off. We were talking about goals, and I think the last thing that I left you on was the path. We are, of course, on Natalie Bacon's blog, nataliebacon.com. I do not know who she is. I do not listen to her podcast. Was I surprised to learn she had a podcast? No. She seems to be very self-helpy, very life coachy, but she does have this blog article. I guess it's just a blog. Don't need to also call it an article about the 10 goal setting mistakes you're making. I'll point that finger at me. She does have a how to live an intentional life free course available. If you want to jump on there, access that course. Sorry, I don't mean to be sarcastic about all of this stuff, but I've gone down this rabbit hole before, babe. Okay. Okay. So we went over not writing down your goals. That's a mistake. Not using a task manager. That's a mistake. She was talking about the dream year, which I think is her creation, and the productivity planner, which I told you that I'm familiar with because it was very big on the journaling YouTube channels in like 2016, 2017, along with the traveler notebook. When people were just really hot and bothered about bullet journaling. So let's talk about the PATH method, which is I think we started discussing because of not setting a deadline for your goals is number 3. And it kind of went with the task manager thing. So the PATH system developed by these two ladies, I don't know if they were a part of UCB or a part of the comedy scene in New York in general, but I do know that like a lot of the people at UCB took their class and benefited from it. And basically it looks at your goals in terms of a 2-year period. So it has you do a bunch of different sort of exercises to discover like what you truly want. You know, get down to the nitty gritty of it all. And then once you've discovered that, you kind of walk back and I've done it like secondhand. I've done like the bootleg version where a friend will take the course and then give me the pamphlets or walk me through the process. But basically you have your goal at the end of 2 years and you go, okay, if this is my goal in 2 years, what do I need to have accomplished in a year? And then you write that out. Okay, if that's my goal for that year, what do I need to have accomplished in 6 months? You write that out. What do I need to have accomplished in 3 months? You write that out. What do I need to have accomplished in 2 weeks? You write that out. What do I need to have accomplished today? You know, so you get down, 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 down. So that way you have a map that leads you straight to your future self that is successful, happy, thin and young. And that is at the end of that 2 years. They also have you do this thing that I've done a few times. And I do actually think it's helpful. I was really skeptical about it before, but you write out 50 different tasks that you could do that lead to accomplishing that goal. So like, let's say your goal is to write a screenplay. What are like 50 different things you could do? Or let's say your task is to sell a screenplay. Okay, let's do that. Because then one of your tasks might be write the screenplay, outline the screenplay, read screenplays, reach out to people you know who've written one, you know, do some investigation work, send it out, put it in competitions, blah, blah, blah. So if you write out 50 things, you start getting to like little things you wouldn't have even thought of, like watch an hour long Skillshare video about it, or, you know, watch a movie and take notes. You know, it makes you be creative in terms of thinking of things you could do. And then you're supposed to do like 3 of those things a week, if I remember correctly. But again, I never took the class. I just benefited from other people taking the class. Let's get back to Natalie Bacon's blog. Number three, not setting a deadline for your goals is one of your mistakes. If you don't set a deadline, you haven't really set a goal. It's more like a wish, and that just isn't helpful. You'll find that oh my God, you're kidding me. Wow. Okay. I guess we're going to finish this article on Friday, and maybe I won't talk about the path at all, because I do think that that ate up most of our time. Okay, let's get comfortable. What am I going to do for the next 25 minutes? I'm still kind of like in what I'm doing, but I'm also getting bored with it. So I'm going to do it a little bit, and then I'm going to look at my to-do list and my notebook and pick one thing from there and do that for the last half of the 25 minutes. What are you going to work on? Great. I put 25 minutes on the clock. Get comfortable. Get ready. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. dear friends, dear pals, dear study buddies, we have reached the end of this hour. I'm feeling good. I got a lot done. I never got into my to-do list, but I think I'm done with my research. So Friday, I can do whatever I want. I might have a whole new plate of tasks to take care of that day. But right now I'm feeling good. I'm feeling fresh. I think I might go rollerblading. Is that wild? It's a beautiful day. Thank you so much for working with me. I really appreciate it. I will see you here on Friday at 10 a.m. Okay. Bye.